All right, what's going on, folks? This is Clayton over at AndroidAuthority.com, and today I'm bringing you a head-to-head comparison of the Adaptex keyboard, the Slide It keyboard, the Swift Key X keyboard, and then I'm throwing in the Ice Cream Sandwich stock keyboard. So without further ado, let's just check out some of the user interface of these keyboards. On my LG Optimus 4X, I am running the Adaptex keyboard, as you can see here. We've got our clean user interface with our suggestion bar at top. You can check out a review on the website of this keyboard. And then on the Galaxy Nexus, I'm running the Slide It keyboard. If we compare the two user interfaces, we can see that there's like more of a clean user interface here on the Adaptex keyboard, and then on the Slide It, there's like this 3D thing going on. But of course, we can change the themes on each of these, so I'll just go through the themes of both. Okay, so first off, we'll just go to the settings on both of these phones. You can see we have the settings open on the Slide It keyboard, and we're just going to open the settings on the Adaptex. Now we have the dictionaries for both, the look and feel for both, but we'll go to the look and feel for the Slide It. You can see that we have the Slide It 3D, and then we got the classic skin, but I'll apply the classic skin. We'll use that. We have the themes here for the Adaptex, and I will change that. Actually, I'm going to keep that on the dark theme. The light one's kind of cool, but you can see what was going on there. We have our automatic text replacement on the Adaptex, and we don't have that on the Slide It, but we're just going to go back and compare the user interface right now. Anyways, on our Adaptex, you see here we have our clean black user interface with our suggestion bar here at the top, and then on our Slide It, we have our nice white user interface with some black buttons, and we can either choose Slide It or ABC, where we cannot slide, because sliding is not allowed in ABC mode. But anyways, the two main features going for each of these, the Adaptex is our word prediction and our automatic text replacement, and then our Slide It is our ease of use and speed of typing by sliding the keyboard. So let's just do a practice sentence with each, and we'll compare if I can actually get one off faster on the Slide It keyboard or on the Adaptex using the prediction. So for our sentence, I will put, "I love Android Authority." And I typed that pretty sloppily, but as you can see, it's still got I Love Android Authority on there. And that was a pretty quick time, you know, like I didn't really have to use the text suggestion or the auto prediction on there. Kind of knew what I was going to type because I imported my dictionary from Facebook and from my Android dictionary. But we'll kind of do the same thing here on the Galaxy Nexus running the Slide It keyboard right now. We'll unlock, open it up. And we will use the Slide I Love Android Authority. Oh, and it didn't even get the last one. And it actually spelled live. So maybe I was going a little fast on the Slide It keyboard, but we will try it again right now just to see if I can do it. I'll take my time a little more now. So, and it automatically puts the spaces in after I press I. So I love Android. And it didn't get authority again. The Slide It keyboard took a little more time than the Adaptex keyboard. Anyways, the Slide It can be very useful, and you know, you can get sentences off pretty quickly using the Slide It keyboard. We'll just compare a few of the other functionalities now. Anyways, on the Adaptex keyboard, we have our numbers and punctuation button, which when we press, we have two options of menus to go through, where we have our punctuation and a few emoticons. And then on the Slide It, we have the same numbers and punctuation, but we have four different panels, and the numbers stay constant, but we do have four different panels, including some arrow keys on there. And then anyways, on the Slide It keyboard, we do have our settings cut, copy, and paste, so that's pretty convenient, and then we can actually pin to our clipboard and whatnot. But, you know, the Adaptex and the Slide It, it comes down to preference. If you prefer the automatic text replacement and the text prediction of the Adaptex over the speed and ease of use of the Slide It keyboard, you know, it's just all your choice. So that's those. Alrighty, so next we've got our Adaptex keyboard versus the Swift Key X keyboard. Now these are both more similar this time, and when we type on the Swift Key X, we actually get a few, you know, predictions there like we do on the Adaptex keyboard. So these are more similar, they're in the same ballpark as opposed to the Slide It keyboard versus the Adaptex. But anyways, we can go ahead and check our numbers and punctuation buttons. When we press that on the Swift Key X, we get our numbers that we can easily hit with our left finger pretty easily, get our numbers in there and everything, and then our punctuation's there on the right, and then we have our emoticons there. Anyways, when we press that on the Adaptex, of course we have our two pages of text, and we can go to our settings on each. Actually, that would be this key. And when we are in our settings on the AdaptX, as we previously saw, we have our themes, the auto correction, and all that. And on the SwiftKey X, we have our personalization and our themes, of course. And then we have our SwiftKey X stats, which are pretty cool because it shows us how much more efficient we are just by using the SwiftKey keyboard. Anyways, let's do some typing tests on this one. And same with the AdaptX keyboard. We'll see if our prediction is better on the SwiftKey X or on the AdaptX. So I'll just go ahead and type a sentence in on the Galaxy Nexus running the SwiftKey, and we will put the auto prediction on this keyboard is great. Now, it got most of them. It did say predictions instead of prediction and auto instead of auto, but I was typing pretty sloppily, but I'm kind of trying to do that just to see how well it can predict a word from something that is not a word. Now, anyways, we'll try that on the AdaptText. The auto predictions on this keyboard is great. So, I kind of did that one sloppy again, but it says thaw, auto prediction on this keyboard, mistreat. Now, I don't know if I was typing too sloppy, but it would seem that the SwiftKey got it a little better than the AdaptX keyboard. Now, I was typing pretty sloppy, but then again, I was doing that on purpose to try and, you know, basically see how well these two keyboards can create words based on their context and whatnot. But anyways, it does look like the SwiftKey was a little bit better than the AdaptX. So, you know, it's all preference again, you guys. Alright guys, so last but not least, we have our AdaptX beta keyboard versus the stock Android ice cream sandwich keyboard that comes on phones like the Galaxy Nexus. Anyways, when we compare the user interfaces of these two, we can see that the stock keyboard is lacking the secondary, you know, numbers and punctuation above these letters that you can get while you long press on the AdaptX keyboard. But it does not lack auto text prediction and you know, the learning of words that you type. Anyways, we have our number 1, 2, 3 ABC, where we can go to our pages of punctuation and characters and whatnot, just like we can on the AdaptX keyboard. And both of them work pretty nicely. You know, when you're typing, they have good prediction on both, and you know, they're both solid keyboards. We'll just do a quick typing test, and this we will put. Let's see if the stock keyboard can stand up. Well, typed perfectly, no errors, and it was a moderately fast pace, you know, about as fast as I can go accurately. And we will type the same thing on the AdaptX keyboard. Let's see if the stock keyboard can stand up. And it typed it perfectly there, and I think, you know, I tried to go a little bit faster on the AdaptX keyboard anyways. But so yeah, it typed it on the AdaptX keyboard perfectly, and it also typed it on the stock keyboard perfectly too. So when it comes down to it, you know, you're basically just going to have to choose your own personal preference. A lot of the keyboards we've seen today are great keyboards, and the AdaptX keyboard can run with the pack, and all the other ones can run with the pack. So, you know, it really does come down to preference, you guys. But that was our video. If you like it, subscribe to AndroidAuthority.com, and you can check out more videos like this.